much. It's not enough. You love blow and I love puff. And life is like a pipe. And I'm a tiny penny rolling up the walls inside.
I knew about Amy a little bit.
We
2003 around Carnival. I think that's right when Frank dropped. So I remember just seeing these posters everywhere. She was like smiling, laughing in this picture, and she looked kind of hot. Guy Moot, who was the head of EMI Publishing, said, "Do you know Amy Winehouse? She's in New York for like a day. Do you want to meet with her?" And I was like, "Yeah, I remember like that thing she put out." And we're sitting in my studio and I'm like, "So what kind of record do you want to make?" She's like, "I've been listening to all this girl group stuff like the Shangri-Las, and I love this music." I was messing around the piano and I don't know exactly where it came from, but I played something that I thought sounded like something that she would dig and was a bit reminiscent of the things she'd been playing, and I came up with the chords, the piano chords, the back to back, the bam 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 bam. This is cool. I don't know what this is, but it seems like a vibe. So then I went, I had a little drum kit. Just played like boom, tss, boom, tss. And then I remember like thinking like, okay, well, let me put like a bunch of like fake reverb on the tambourine. So it's like, tsh, like give it like my fake version of like Wall of Sound, like this thing that she likes. I was probably there till like 3 or 4 in the morning, came back at like noon and she came. And I was like, I did something last night. Like inspired by what you're talking about, see what you think. And she's kind of like sitting behind me and I play it and I'm kind of trying to read her while I'm playing it, and she's kind of just like very like, it's impossible to read. And I was like, oh, it's not moving, you know, like I can just tell, like, oh, whatever, it doesn't matter, it's like, it's not the end of the world. And she's like, this is what I want my whole album to sound like, I love it. And I was like, cool, great. And she took headphones and a little Discman and went in the back room where we had like the drums set up by herself for an hour and just came back and had written back to black.
He left no time to regret. Kept his dick away with his same old safe bag. Me and my head high and my tears dry, get on without my guy.
By the third or fourth day, the first time I did something that she didn't like, I was working on this instrumental track and she came, I was like, do you like this? And it was like a little too like clap busy, like funky, and she was like, no. I started kind of scrambling, like taking different things out of the track, like whatever, what about now, like is it that thing you don't like if I take that shaker out? She's like, Mark, it's shit, like why are you trying to fix it? While that bluntness kind of stung quite a bit for like probably an hour, like it was a good lesson in just like how to just make better shit and just be more honest.
We got to talk about Back to Black, which is just one of the best albums of the century. I mean, an extraordinary album. His ability to create like a kind of backdrop in front of which Amy was able to let rip the most emotional songs. It was incredible.
The winner of the best British female, Amy Winehouse!
The voice alone would have been enough if she never wrote a song to it. Then the fact that she could play this music, was so frank and honest, and then had the command of language to actually convey those emotions in the most insanely clever, poetic way.
Hey, what can I say? Thank you very much. Thank you.
I mean, of course, it suited me in my life to be the producer, really, because I didn't want to express my emotions anyway. I didn't feel comfortable doing that, so it's easy to, like, and they become then, like, chicken or egg, like, are you the producer because you, like, do you engage in these tactics and take on these character traits because they kind of serve you, and like the fact that you don't really want to have to ever express yourself, open up. I mean, there's something that I always really like think about, that like, as somebody who came from like a fairly turbulent childhood, it makes sense that like I kind of zeroed in on the role where like I would spend as much time in a room by myself as possible, be the complete captain of my own ship, and nobody could really tell me what to do.